Lesson 15. The first word, 认识. See, the second character is a neuter tongue. 认识 is a verb, means to meet, to know. Let's look at how to use it. 2个月前, 我不认识王老师。 王老师也不认识我。 2个月前, 2 months ago, right? 我不认识王老师, I don't know 王老师. 王老师 also don't know me. 我不认识王老师, 王老师也不认识我, 也不认识我. Okay, but now, 现在我们认识了。 Now we know each other. Okay, here I put a le at the end of sentence to indicate the change. The change of a situation from we don't know each other to we know each other. It's a change. 我们认识了。你认识那个医生吗? 你认识那个医生吗? So it means, do you know that doctor? 你认识那个医生吗? 我很想去认识他。很想, remember its meaning, would like do something. 我很想去认识他, I really want to know him. 我很想去认识他. Besides, see here, after 认识, we use a person. Besides this, we can also put a particular place after 认识. For example, 你认识那个商店吗? 你认识那个商店吗? 在北京路, Beijing Road. 你认识那个商店吗? Here, 路 means road. 你认识那个商店吗? Do you know that shop? 请问医院怎么去? 那怎么? Remember its meaning? 怎么? It means how. We use the how, 怎么 before a verb, how to do something. 怎么去? How to get there. 我不认识那儿。 So it means I don't know that. 年 is a noun, means year. We have learned this one. 今天,昨天,明天, what's the meaning? 昨天, yesterday, right? 今天, today, and 明天, tomorrow. How to describe 年? 今年, we have learned it. It means this year. 今年, and same with 明天. If you want to say next year, we can use 明年, but last year is different. 昨天 means yesterday, but last year we should use 去年. We have learned 去 is a verb, means to go, right? So that year has gone, right? So that is 去年, that year has gone. 去年, last year. Let's look at some sentences. Actually, 去年, 明年, they are time word. If it's a time word, we should put them before the verb. Or you can also put them before the subject. 我们去年去了北京。去年, last year. So, 去北京, this action has already happened. That's why I use a le after 去 to indicate this action has completed. It's already happened. 我们去年去了北京。明年我十三岁了。明年我十三岁了。 So here, this le indicates a change. This year, I'm 12. Next year, from 12 to 13, 我十三岁了. It's a change. The change of your age. Okay, now we can describe, we can express this date in Chinese. This one is a year. When we read the year, we should read the numbers digit by digit, one by one. 2020年8月21号。 Do you remember? In Chinese, the bigger unit should be put before the smaller one. That's why we should